King of the Jews by Leslie Epstein. This book is read by Edward Lewis. Chapter 1. The Golden Age. In the winter of 1918 to 1919, on a day when the wind was blowing, I. C. Trumpelman arrived in our town. He was wearing a brown overcoat and a brown hat and had a large suitcase in either hand. The overcoat was a cheap one, woven from horsehair. "Mister," he said in Polish to the first person he saw on the platform, "find me a hotel." For such a large man his voice was high, with a trace of the lisp that Jews have in Vilna. Even at that time his hair was gray, almost white, and hung far over his collar. His eyes peered through the same pair of American spectacles, round lenses in black metal frames, that he was to wear 20 and 25 years later. The eyes themselves were also round, like a boy's, and were, for a Litvak, remarkably blue. Our main station, like many others built in the 1880s, was designed by the Italian Donati. It is to this day still standing, with turrets of red brick, with stone buttresses, with slanted windows through which you can see clouds and birds, and the lemon-colored lozenge of the Polish sun. The man on the platform, the one Trumpelman spoke to, led him through the station arches and out into the winter light. Although he was not a railway porter and not even a member of the working class, this Pole carried both of the Jews' valises. The newcomer, now standing on the steps of the Donati station, put his hand on his hat and stared through the central square. There were carts there, and wagons, and several automobiles. Toward the east, over the rooftops, steam from the dye works steadily rose. Women passed with their bundles. Boys chased each other in the open air. Then the Pole pointed to where, on the far side of the Rumkowski monument, a flag was flying over the Hotel Europa. Trumpelman, with his teeth protruding a little, smiled. Then he picked up his bags and walked down the steps into the square. The tails of his coat, as if angry at something, lashed round his legs. The Hotel Europa, still intact also, though now the site of a state ministry, is even larger than the main station. It was generally thought to be the equal of the Britannia in Warsaw, and finer than the Sopot Casino Hotel in Gottendorf-Lanz. The pastry shop on the ground floor had an international reputation. It made butter tarts with crumb crusts that were toasted, and those traveling east-west, Paris-Moscow, or north-south, Danzig-Budapest, would buy them in between trains. In this hotel, in a corner room with a wash stand, Isaiah C. Trumpelman stayed for 3 nights and 3 days. It seems he spent this time walking in wider and wider circles so as to cover the entire town. Thus, the first day, he stayed near the central square, in the commercial district, and especially on Alexandrovska Boulevard, with its travel posters and elegant shops. The next day, he went to the residential sections, the Walburska Quarter, the twin avenues, Lechica and Pabianica, whose large houses were set into gardens and decorated with a pattern of banana leaves. Finally, he went past the new market to the working-class district known as the Baluti suburb. Here everything smelled from the tanneries, the dye-works and mills were always steaming, and there was mud in all of the roads. So much for Trumpelmann's days. At night, at least for the first night and the second, no person saw him. Probably he was sleeping or reading, or staring out the single round window high up on the wall of his room. The third night was different. The Lithuanian walked out the front door of the hotel. Now he wore blue, the trousers, the jacket, the blue white dotted tie, a white shirt also, and a pair of long, narrow, shiny black shoes. Dressed in these clothes, which set off his eyes, and with his whitish hair brushed over his collar, he must have made a striking figure. He walked through the square and onto a side street, down which, blinking excitedly, were the lights from the Astoria Café. That night spot was not then as famous as it later became. Trumpelman took a table at the back. He ate a beefsteak and drank a clear liqueur. He bought 4 cigarettes. A thin comedian, losing his hair, told a number of jokes. About the Jew in the bathtub. About the landowner and the crow. Then a woman with black bangs and painted lips began to sing songs. She looked, with her straight, bare shoulders, like a statuette, like an Egyptian. The visitor at the far table ordered a hothouse flower and, when the songs were over, sent it to the stage. The singer pinned the rose to her waist, just above the split in her tight, gleaming gown. Then she blew that patron a kiss. It was in this manner that I. C. Trumpelman celebrated his 49th birthday.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.